Very good morning, my dear students of class 10th. Act 3, scene 2 is being taught nowadays of the drama The Merchant of Venice. You please open Act 3, scene 2, line number 275. Here, you see the speech of Salerio. He says, "Not one, my lord. Besides, it should appear that if he had the present money to discharge the Jew, he would not take it. Not a single one, my lord." When Bassanio asked him, "Has not one ship spared from being wrecked on the dangerous rocks that often ruin merchants?" Then Salerio says, "Not a single one, my lord. Further, it seems that even if he had money to repay the Jew, even if he had money to repay the Jew, Shylock would not take it from him now. He would not take it. Never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man, so keen and greedy to confound a man." Salerio says, "Never have I come across such a man, such a creature in the form of a man, so eager and greedy to destroy another man. I have never seen. He plies the Duke at morning and at night. He appeals to the Duke morning and evening, and doth impeach the freedom of the state if they deny him justice. He threatens legal action against the country's system of justice if they deny it to him. 20 merchants, the Duke himself, and the magnificos of great port have all persuaded with him. 20 merchants, the Duke himself, and the noblemen of the highest rank have advised him, but no one can prevent him from his revengeful claim for giving up the conditions of the bond. But none can drive him from the envious plea of forfeiture of justice and his bond. All people tried. The people of highest rank, Duke himself, nobleman, their labor went in vain. But no one can prevent him from his revengeful claim for giving up the conditions of the bond and fulfillment of his legal demand." Jessica says, "When I was with him, I have heard him swear to Tubal and to Cus, his countrymen, that he would rather have Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the sum that he did owe him." Jessica says, "When I was with him, with his father, with her own father, I heard Shylock, his father, to Tubal. He was saying, 'Tubal, Cus and other Jews, that he would rather have a pound of Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the debt. He was saying to his friend that though 20 times money will be repaid him, but he would deny it. 20 times he would deny. I know well my Lord, she says, and I know my Lord, if law, authority and power deny not, it will go hard with poor Antonio. She says, I know well my Lord, that unless the law and the higher powers intervene, interrupt, it will be difficult for Antonio. It will be difficult for poor Antonio. It will be very difficult for poor Antonio. Portia says, is it your dear friend that is thus in trouble? Is it your dear friend who is in this trouble? Bassanio says, their dearest friend to me, the kindest man, the best condition and unwearied spirit. In doing courtesies, and one in whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws breath in Italy. She says, Bassanio says, yes, my dearest friend. Yes, he's my dearest friend. The kindest man, the best intentioned man, never tired in showing kindness to others. He always showed kindness to others. He displays the old Roman spirit of honor more than any other person now living in Italy. His most honorable person in Italy. Portia says, what sum owes he the Jew? How much money does he owe to the Jew? How much? Bassanio says, for me, 3,000 ducats. On my behalf, he owes 3,000 ducats. Portia says, what? No more. Pay him 6,000 and deface the bond. What? That is, pay him 6,000 ducats and cancel the bond. And then treble that before a friend of this description shall lose a hair through Bassanio's fault. Double the 6,000. If he is not satisfied, double the 6,000 and then multiply that by 3, rather than let such a friend suffer the slightest harm through a fault of Bassanio. And what happened after that, you will study in my next video. Thank you so much, students.